back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a review of The Anomaly by Michael Rutger. This was my June pick for the Book of the Month Club, and the reason that it pulled me in was because they described it as Indiana Jones meets The X-Files. And although I'm not a huge fan of Indiana Jones, I am a fan of The X-Files. It's my all-time favorite show, so I couldn't resist this one. In this book, we're following a group of people who are putting together a YouTube docu-series type thing where they are going to explore caverns in the Grand Canyon that are thought to not exist. There's kind of a conspiracy behind it that the Smithsonian, you know, hid information about this cavern, didn't want people to know about it, but they're going to go and prove that it actually exists. So our main character, Nolan, this is like from his point of view, basically telling you a story of what happened to them when they went on this adventure. He is the host of the YouTube series. He is known as being a conspiracy theorist, and that kind of makes people like not trust him, I guess. They say he's not legitimate, he's not credible, because he is known for searching for odd things or things thought to not exist or things surrounding different conspiracy theories. So basically people think he's a quack. And on this trip, he goes with a couple producers, a cameraman. There is a woman who goes along with them who is a sponsor or a representative of a company who is sponsoring this trip and kind of like sponsoring the show that they're doing. And then we also have an investigative journalist that goes along with them. She's kind of one of those people who are fueling the fire of that he's a quack and this isn't real science and how do you, you know, like this isn't real, there's no proof, blah, blah, blah. But I would say for Nolan, he's kind of like a Fox Mulder because he's so into conspiracy theories. But also, I would say he reminded me a little bit of Ben Gates from National Treasure, always spitting facts, always just having an explanation for things and just kind of going down like this rabbit hole of spilling all this information and historical data and things like that. He is very comedic and sarcastic in his narrative. It's almost like he wants people to think that he's a quack. He puts himself down, it seems like, and you can't really tell, like, is this just like an issue he has, or is there more to that? Is, you know, he doesn't want people to believe him because then when he does find something, it'll be way more mind-blowing than it would have been if everyone believed him right off the bat. But basically, this team, they go to the Grand Canyon in search for Kincaid's cavern, and G.E. Kincaid is actually a man who in the early 1900s reported to the newspaper and to the Smithsonian that he had found this cave and that it was full of relics, and I think they reference it as being full of wonders. And the Smithsonian kind of like hushed it up from what I gathered, and so now Nolan, the main character, the host, and his team are out to record their adventure and to finding this cavern. And they do find it. They find that there are, it's like a cave, a cavern, with a bunch of different tunnels, and they find writing on the wall, they find weird, like little statues and things of that sort. But when they first get there, they find that different parts have been sealed off, and they don't really know why. And then, of course, once they're down there, things start to get weird, and basically the cavern itself seems to start attacking or taking over the expedition, and this turns into a story of survival. They become trapped in this cavern, and they're trying to find a way out while combating everything that is going on with this cavern and what the cavern is doing to them and what the cavern is doing to itself. I don't want to say much else. The flap doesn't give you too much more information other than that. I, though, would recommend this book if you are a sci-fi adventure type reader, if you enjoyed Indiana Jones, National Treasure, and The X-Files. I could see how all of those play into this book. Michael Rutger is actually a screenwriter, and I feel like you can kind of tell in this book, we're kind of just, it gets to the point pretty quick, but also every single chapter is a cliffhanger. Well, almost every single chapter is some sort of cliffhanger. There are a few plot twists, a few twists and turns that you don't see coming, that you don't expect. The weird science behind what is happening is interesting. But I do think that if you are into sci-fi and adventure novels, then you would enjoy this. I enjoy the way it's written. I like the whole basically being told a story from the character's point of view after everything has occurred. I enjoyed the main characters, everyone who's a part of the expedition team. I really like Nolan, the lead. He, even though he is that comedic and sarcastic, I feel like he could be an unlikable narrator or an unlikable character, but with that, that's what kind of made me like him. But I ended up giving this like a 3.5 out of 4 stars. It's really enjoyable, and it's one of those books where you want to keep reading to find out what happens, especially because of all the cliffhangers. Like, at the end of a lot of the chapters, eventually I was like, okay, come on, like, how many times do we have to do this? But I did really enjoy it, and I would recommend it. I'm kind of surprised at how much I liked it, just because I was just worried. I always am a little iffy about sci-fi. Let me know if you're going to pick this book up, or if you've read it. Let me know what you think down below, and I'll see you in my next video.